Thank you. How would it look like? Yeah. They had chairs and shit.
Take you about. Yeah. Good morning, everybody. Please remain standing. As we begin our program this morning, I want to first thank Ms. Marion Brown, the maestro of this great event. Marion, thank you. And I also want to recognize, I'm not supposed to ever play favorites, but I do have a favorite in the room, and that is our First Lady, Ms. Cindy Howard Stewart. Cindy, I don't know where you are. Thank you. Welcome to the University of Montevallo's 127th Founders Day celebration. I would like to thank Dr. Laurie Medall, class of 88, for today's prelude and processional music. Now, may I ask that Mr. Colton Redano, president of the Student Government Association, to come forward and deliver the invocation, following Mr. Josh Giles, class of 24, will lead us in the singing of our national anthem.
Thank you, Dr. Stewart, and thank you everyone for being here today. May we all pray. Our Father, we here at the University of Montevallo are thankful to have the opportunity to celebrate Founders Day on the 127th anniversary of our beloved institution. On October 12, 1896, our university was founded as the Alabama Girls Industrial School and has evolved to become Alabama's leading liberal arts university. Our university has produced some of our state and country's finest leaders, ranging from deans of law schools to attorneys at the Department of Justice. I expect that some future leaders are here today wearing their senior robes for the first time, fully prepared through their liberal arts education to take on the world. With each graduating generation of students, my optimism and hope for the future grows as I see the altruism and selflessness that guides us. This effect is most prominent here in Montevallo, where students and faculty have operated personally and compassionately for over a century to study and solve the many issues we have faced and will face. I am grateful to be a part of this community, and I pray that we all achieve the greatest success. I also pray that those who come after us do great things and honor the legacy that has been forged by our institution and those who graduated before them. Our education has prepared us, and we need only act to secure this reality. Thank you.
Please be seated. Thank you, Colton and Josh. Josh, the Super Bowl committee just called. In the late 1800s, as Senator Solomon Block of Camden, Alabama, traveled the roads of our state, he increasingly witnessed many young women relegated to work in the fields to earn a meager living. There was little opportunity or training for women, and Senator Block found this intolerable. This inspired him to become a powerful voice for change in the legislature. Also at the time, the state of Alabama was fortunate to have among its citizenry a fierce advocate for women's education, the reformer and educator, Julia Tutwiler. Through the cooperation and commitment, a mere hope and an uncertain idea became a reality that has transformed the lives of over 26,000 women and men. On October 12, 1896, 400 people anxiously awaited the day's celebration in Reynolds Hall. Another 400 clamored around the outside of Reynolds with excitement as Shelby County and the town of Montevallo could now boast the opening of its own industrial school. From townspeople and statesmen, farmers and business owners, to students and parents, all stood shoulder to shoulder in celebration of their collective efforts to bring forth this institution, which stands today as the University of Montevallo. Today, we honor those who laid a firm foundation as we, again, are together, shoulder to shoulder, 127 years later, as a university and greater community. And now I would like to introduce some individuals who you will not otherwise meet today during the ceremony, but are very important to us. As I introduce you, I ask that you stand and remain standing until all are recognized. The Honorable Todd Strange, Chairman of the University of Montevallo Board of Trustees. Ms. Cynthia Todd, UM Board of Trustees. The Honorable Matt Friday, UM Board of Trustees. And I'm not sure if Anita Bruick was able to make it today. She was on the program, but I don't see Anita here today. Dr. Donna Plessel, Interim Dean of the College of Education and Human Development. Dr. Amy Mellon, Dean of the Michael E. Stevens College of Business. Dr. Stephen Peters, Dean of the College of Fine Arts. And Dr. Robert Barone, Academic Grand Marshal. And don't worry, I think you're going to see Dr. Truss later. Also with us are individuals and groups who merit our recognition. Please stand as I introduce you. Do we have any representatives of the City of Montevallo and Shelby County, representatives of the University of Montevallo National Alumni Association, Junior Board, members of the UM Foundation Board, members of the 1896 Society, and may I ask that all of those who are in attendance and have served in the military or veterans, please stand. And finally, will all alumni of our university please stand? Also with us are several family members of our alumni, faculty, and staff who will be honored today. As I introduce you, please stand and remain standing until all are introduced. The parents of our keynote speaker, Joseph and Joy Maloney, who I believe are live streaming from home, and Julia's partner, Christopher Campbell. Chris, if you would stand up, please. And by the way, Chris is a rabid Georgia Bulldog fan, for any of our students from Georgia. Leslie Allen and Nate, wife and son, Nancy Potts and John McAndrew, mother and stepfather, and Rich and Rhonda Richardson, father and stepmother of our university scholar. Avery Patton, Ashley Bennett, and Abby Hankins, daughters of our adjunct teaching award winner. Gary and Sharon Minnick, parents. David and Kathy Thomas, mother and father-in-law. And B.J. Posey and Meredith Waldrop, friends of our Staff Service Award winner. Cindy Holsenbach, sister, and Linda Mahan, friend of the Johnny D. Holsenbach Shine Award recipient. And Eliza Newell, daughter, Terry and Reba Newell, parents, Tara Mack, sister, and Jeremy Ward and Matt Walker, friends of our Outstanding Commitment to Teaching Award. Thank you all. Later today, the university will launch a comprehensive fundraising campaign that will endow scholarships for our students, provide financial and material resources to our academic family, as well as support expanding opportunities and services. The campaign is entitled Momentum, Your Moment, Their Future. The campaign for the University of Montevallo will help not only students who are currently here, but faculty who teach you in the classroom. Students, your ideas, broad knowledge, and desire for truth illustrates our mission and the value of a liberal arts education, which will carry you throughout your lives wherever you may journey. You are the living, walking, and talking campaign for the University of Montevallo, and we thank you. Seniors, as we embark on this important part of the convocation, please take this moment to reflect on your time here. Consider your challenges and successes, those who helped you reach this day, and the friends and memories that will remain with you always. And now may I invite Senior Vice President and Provost, Dr. Courtney Bentley, to come to the podium and ask Senior Class President, Ms. Abigail Hooten, to join her at the podium for the 81-year tradition of the formal investiture or robing of the senior class.
Ms. Hooten, will you please join me beside the podium? This duty is a distinct honor. It recognizes both personal and academic growth and celebrates your achievements. Seniors, please refer to the class pledge located in your program. I will ask you to stand with your robes as we recite the pledge together. At the conclusion, I will robe Ms. Hooten. As I do so, you may also put on your academic gowns. Stand, thank you.
In full consciousness of the truth and responsibility signified by the bestowal of this cap and gown, I do hereby pledge myself to uphold to the best of my ability the faith manifested in me by the University of Montevallo. You may be seated. Please join me in congratulating our seniors.
Congratulations, seniors. This marks your official entry into the community of scholars, and even though it is your final Founders Day as students, we look forward to seeing you here again as alumni. I offer my very best wishes for a successful senior year and a bright future beyond. In 1926, a unique tradition was begun by seniors at the university who felt the juniors needed to make the transition from junior to an exalted senior. The senior women hid the crook somewhere on campus for the juniors to find. As times changed, so did finding the crook. Since 1999, finding the crook has been open to all students each year. The Founders Day Committee determines where it will be hidden and publishes clues as to its mysterious location. This year, the crook was hidden at Myrick Hall in celebration of UM's new nursing program. I am pleased to announce that Rachel Johnson, Cole Swain, and Lucy Frost Helms found the crook for the third year in a row. A three-peat, another three-peat. True Montevallo sleuths, congratulations to each of you, our Sherlock Holmes. Please come to the stage and take a bow.
this is.
Seniors, as your undergraduate days come to a close, the years ahead will be filled with opportunities and excitement. In 2013, our Founders Day speaker was sitting here just like you, wondering what the future may hold. A mere 10 years later, she returns to the stage as our honored keynote speaker with accomplishments and accolades that most did not achieve in 20 years. As a student, she pursued both passion and purpose and was a founding member and president of the music honorary fraternity, Sigma Alpha Lambda. She served within UM's Student Government Association, participated in College Night, and achieved senior elite status in her major, political science. After graduating from UM, she was accepted to the University of Virginia School of Law, where she became editor-in-chief of the Virginia Journal of Criminal Law. Then came the internship, with 2 years as a law clerk. That resilience was rewarded through the Attorney General of the United States Honors Program, where Ms. Julia Maloney was hired as a trial attorney for the United States Department of Justice Antitrust Division in 2019. In 4 short years, Julia has received 2 Assistant Attorney General's Awards and an Award of Excellence from the U.S. Department of Energy. She served as first chair counsel in over 36 criminal bench trials, presented witnesses and indictments to grand juries, crafted plea agreements, successfully prosecuted 3 federal jury trials, and served as lead negotiator in antitrust cases that resulted in over $600 million in criminal fines. Julia, your dedication and energy is amazing and inspiring to us. You are truly a living campaign for the University of Montevallo, and I'm excited to see what the next years hold for you. Your alma mater is very proud. It is now my pleasure to invite to the podium Ms. Julia Maloney, class of 2013, to deliver our keynote address.
As an aside, Dr. Stewart, it's 4 jury trials now. Good morning, everyone, and thank you so much to Dr. Stewart, Marion Brown, and everyone involved in putting together this incredible event. And thank you all so much for inviting me to come speak to you today. When Dr. Stewart first asked me if I would be the keynote speaker for today's event, I'll be honest, I hesitated. Not because I didn't want to, but because I was certain he had made a mistake. Surely he intended to ask somebody more accomplished, somebody more eloquent, somebody more impressive. And for all of his amazing traits, Dr. Stewart does not seem to have realized that he made a mistake. So here I am, thrilled, grateful, and incredibly honored to be speaking before you all today. I was told the theme of today's Founders Day is momentum. And to be honest, I don't know how I feel about that theme. Because when I think of momentum, I think of a great mountain, perfectly smooth, and a boulder at the very top, rolling down. The boulder rolls slowly at first, but it builds up speed. It builds momentum in a steady, constant fashion. And sorry, Dr. Hope, I know there's a formula for that, but it's been a very long time since intro to physics. But when I think back to how my life has gone so far, that's not quite how it's played out. Sure, there is this great mountain, and there is a boulder. And the boulder is making its way down, but that mountain is not smooth. It's full of bumps and cliffs and holes. Because, you know, life is not just success, it's also failure. There will be stops, there will be starts, there will be problems. And that's what I want to talk to you all about today. Today is a great success. You all have made it so far. Momentum is on your side. And today is a beautiful day, even if it is a little gray out. but not every day will be so beautiful. At some point, you will do your best. You will try your hardest. You will give it your all. And it won't be enough. You will lose. You will be passed over. You may be turned down. And it will hurt a lot. But don't let that deter you. To quote the great Maya Angelou, we may encounter many defeats in life, but we must not be defeated. That is, as long as you keep fighting, keep striving for excellence, you will never truly taste defeat. What matters is not whether you win or lose, it's what you do next. And I'll be honest, it's weird being up here on stage. I haven't set foot in Palmer Hall in over 10 years. And the last time I was here was for a moment of great success. The time before that was a moment of personal great defeat. And one of those moments was college night. It was my senior year here at Montevallo, my last chance at college night. So I poured myself into it. I was in the orchestra. I played 3 different instruments through the show. I did every solo. I gave lessons in my free time. I lost sleep. I skipped class. Sorry, Dr. Turner, my bad. I put everything I had into college night because I thought that victory, that success, it would make my life perfect. It would make me happy. Well, that Saturday night arrived. I was in the pit just down here, and I put everything into it. I was tired, exhausted, hungry, and I was convinced 100% we were going to win. The president came up, stood pretty much where I am right now, actually, and she began her speech. I knew she was going to say my side won. I knew it. We lost. And it broke me. I hadn't done enough. I wasn't good enough. I wasn't enough. That's what I thought. More than 10 years later, I look back at that moment not fondly. College night had seemed so important. It was the thing I needed to succeed. But it wasn't really. Because success, happiness, it can take on so many different forms. It's not as simple as a win or a loss. It's what you do next. You should take a minute, revel in the victory, wallow in the loss, but don't let it define you. Just move on. So that's what I did. I moved on to the next thing, which was my very last wind ensemble concert right here in Palmer Hall. I was terrified. Back then I played the French horn, so that was fun. And I was the featured soloist for a piece, which meant I had to come stand pretty much here and perform in front of the ensemble, in front of the audience, in front of all of these people who I'd known and grown to love over the past 4 years. People I considered my family. And I remember I was terrified. My knees were shaking. The lights, it's these same lights, I'm pretty sure, they're blinding. And I remember the cold metal of my instrument in my sweaty, clammy hands. And I remember hearing the song start, quietly at first, the clarinets, too quiet to make out, the flutes joining in, growing louder. And I took a deep breath, feeling the stress melt away. And then I began to play. The piece was slow, and it was sad, and it was beautiful. And it was not perfect. I could not pull off that final high note, the one that I'd tried so hard for in practice. And I could not pull off that fancy little trill that I was so sure I would get. But to me, it was beautiful. It felt like a step towards something great. It felt like success. It felt like momentum. And you're not the first people I've told these stories to. My application to join the United States Department of Justice, I wrote about college night. My law school application, to join the University of Virginia. I wrote about that wind ensemble concert. Today, my job is to travel around the country, rooting out corruption and fraud. And everywhere I go, I talk to people. I tell them about Alabama. I tell them how we're not just sitting on our front porches, chewing on fat cap and tobacco. I tell them about Montevallo, about this beautiful little town, this beautiful little university, and the beautiful people who call it home. Standing here today, I can tell you all, you will know defeat, but you will know success. And today is a success. You've made it so far. You're soon to graduate from a wonderful university alongside wonderful, incredible people. Many of you may be about to enter the workforce. Others may go on to achieve additional degrees. But whatever lays ahead of you, please remember, it doesn't matter if you win or lose. What matters is what you do next. And wherever you go, wherever that momentum may carry you, please remember, Montevallo will always be here for you. Thank you.
Wow, that was awesome. Thank you, Julie. Could you please join me at the podium again? Julia, we are immensely proud of you, and we're also proud today to offer you the President's Award, and this is presented to you as a distinguished attorney and alumna, and the quote is, "All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them," by Walt Disney, bestowed on October 12, 2023, and we, again, are very proud of you. And now, in honor of our speaker, we will enjoy a special performance by the University Concert Choir under the direction of Mr. Zachary Banks, class of 2008 and 2012. Thank you, Mr. Banks, and thank you to our concert choir. An amazing job. Do you want to do an encore? Yeah. Thank you. Founders Day not only marks a milestone in the life of this university, it is also a time to honor those who make achieving this milestone possible. Today we have several special presentations to express our appreciation for their work and influence within this community and beyond. First, Dr. Ruth Truss, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, will present the 2023 University Scholar. Dr. Catherine Walsh, President of the Faculty Senate, will present Dr. Jermaine B. Mitchell Faculty Service Award. Following, Dr. Bentley will bestow the Adjunct Teaching Award. Then Mr. Aaron Mahaney, President of the Staff Senate, will present the inaugural Johnny D. Holsenbach Shine Award. After these university awards, Ms. Stephanie Ball Shaw, President of the National Alumni Association, will present the Outstanding Staff Service Award, Outstanding Commitment to Teaching Award, and the Mary Lou Elder Williams Alumni Loyalty Award.
What a joy it is to introduce Dr. Betsy Richardson as this year's University Scholar. So, Dr. Richardson, will you join me at the podium? As she's coming up, I'll tell you that a colleague from Virginia Commonwealth University described Dr. Richardson as a powerhouse and a gem. So let me give you just a brief summary of some of her accomplishments. Dr. Richardson joined UM in 2018 and was promoted to associate professor in 2021. During her 5 years at UM, she has published 6 peer-reviewed articles and 4 book chapters, given 12 presentations, and co-authored Pain Psychology for Clinicians, a practical guide for the non-psychologist managing patients with chronic pain, which was published by Oxford University Press. So Dr. Richardson literally wrote the book on the topic of managing chronic pain. Her field is medical clinical psychology. Her research, much of it with veterans, focuses on the biopsychosocial mechanisms of pain. She has served as the PI or co-PI on several NIH and NIDRR grants in the field of spinal cord injury. She is known for innovative lines of inquiry, one of which was a randomized controlled trial using virtual reality as a treatment for chronic neuropathic pain in those with spinal cord injuries or limb amputations. Her research also incorporates novel statistical analysis of cluster data, that's not my words, those are the quote, making use of her postdoctoral master's degree in clinical research biostatistics. With colleagues from Virginia Commonwealth University, UAB, and the University of New South Wales in Sydney, Australia, Dr. Richardson's current research involves a clinical trial funded by the U.S. Department of Defense dealing with spinal cord injury. Using research to inform her teaching is a hallmark of Dr. Richardson's work and speaks to UM's student-centered mission. She has mentored 5 UR undergraduate research projects, and as Dr. Holtquist noted in her nomination letter, her Psychology of Pain course makes UM one of only 6 institutions in North America to offer such a course. Her colleague, Dr. Melissa Shepherd, notes that Dr. Richardson is knowledgeable and reliable, which is sometimes a difficult combination to find in a research collaborator. Indeed, Dr. Richardson is generous and humble, and just happens to be a scholar of national and international standing. After her book was published, Dr. Richardson's spouse referred to her as Dr. Smarty Pants. Frankly, I see no problem with that label. So, Dr. Richardson or Dr. Smarty Pants, whichever you prefer, thank you for sharing your talents with UM and congratulations on this well-deserved recognition.
still get nervous doing this stuff. So, for those of you who know me, you know I have a hard time with compliments. I am working on that. So you definitely know when the spotlight is on my achievements, I am all but squirming. I think the latter is in part because it doesn't really paint the whole picture of all that lies in between those lines on my CV. So I want to echo the message from our keynote speaker that rivaling any list of accomplishments is my share of failed projects, rejection letters, mistakes, facepalm-worthy moments in the lab, of which I have had many. So I don't want to overlook these experiences because I never want to normalize a definition of success that does not include a failure along the way. I've had a lot of that. I owe a great deal of gratitude to many people. I am fortunate to be part of an exceptionally supportive department with fantastic colleagues. Dr. Truss, who was the department chair when I joined UM, deserves special thanks for supporting my research. Even when I was dragging a massive wine chiller around Fallon Hall, that was not for wine. We were not having that good of a time. It was for our cold pain experiments. Dr. Holtquist continued that support, helped us secure formal laboratory space. And I certainly thank Dr. Day for his ongoing support and our psychology lab activities this year. In addition, I'm privileged to work with some outstanding colleagues in our psychology program. This includes Dr. Shepherd and Dr. Gibran. I learn from you both every day, and I'm grateful to be able to collaborate with you both on scholarly projects. I want to express my gratitude to my family, including my mom, my dad, my step-parents. They've accepted me for who I am and never placed expectations as to who I should be. They merely allowed me to pursue what interests me. Leslie, your support means the world to me, giving me time to devote some important project deadlines through the years. I've had a lot of those. How great of a feeling it is to have a cheerleader in your corner through both those successes and all of those failures I just mentioned. Nate, I feel incredibly lucky to be your mom. I am so proud of who you are. Accomplishments and recognitions feel nice, but you are my greatest source of pride. And last but not least, to students, you are the reason for this whole day. As faculty, we are here to share knowledge with you, but we often don't express how much you teach us. It's a joy to witness your growth during your time at Montevallo and to see you evolve into the future generation of valuable scholars, leaders, teachers, and just overall influential individuals that I know that you will become. It gives me such hope for the future. Thank you.
On behalf of the Faculty Senate, I am honored to introduce to you the 2023 recipient of the Dr. Jermaine B. Mitchell Faculty Service Award. Faculty Senate makes this award annually after consideration of nominations from the faculty at large. The award is in memory of Dr. Mitchell and honors his dedication to community service and his impact on the University of Montevallo. This year marks Dr. Susan Kaplow's 10th year of service at the University of Montevallo. Dr. Kaplow is an associate professor of environmental studies. During her tenure at UM, Dr. Kaplow has nurtured the environmental studies program, growing it into a thriving major with broad reach across disciplines. Dr. Kaplow's nominators noted repeatedly how she has fostered meaningful cross-disciplinary connections between faculty and students through her thoughtful management of the environmental studies program. To quote one nominator, "These experiences and relationships that Dr. Kaplow cultivates are a model for the liberal arts experience. This alone is an invaluable service and precious gift to our campus." Dr. Kaplow serves on many, many committees and is the chair of the Sustainability Committee. This committee administers the Green Fund grants. As one nominator wrote, "You are hard pressed to find a space on campus that hasn't been touched by a Green Fund grant." Susan devotes much time, consideration, and passion to this and other endeavors of the committee and of the E-Club for which she is the faculty sponsor. As one example, if you attended the grand Earth Day celebration on Main Quad in spring 2022, you might like to know that the success of this event, or dare I say, awesome party, was in large measure thanks to Dr. Kaplow's enthusiasm and efforts. Because of Dr. Kaplow's roles as Environmental Studies Program Coordinator and Sustainability Coordinator, she manages many related campus resources, among them Ebenezer Swamp, for which she has tirelessly advocated. To highlight some of Dr. Kaplow's service outside of UM, she has for many years served on the Vallow Cycle Board and is instrumental in the success of this community program. She also serves on the board of the Environmental Education Association of Alabama. I cannot agree more fully with Dr. Kaplow's nominators. I'm privileged to have witnessed and experienced the things they wrote about firsthand, serving on the Sustainability Committee, teaching cross-listed courses for the ES program, and in planning the art department's 2020 cross-disciplinary colloquium, to which Dr. Kaplow generously contributed not only a paper, but her time and expertise organizing a session. I share this to illustrate how Dr. Kaplow not only brings together colleagues through environmental studies, but also goes above and beyond to serve and support projects across campus. Through her contributions to the University of Montevallo, the Montevallo community, and the environmental studies field, Dr. Kaplow exemplifies the dedication to service that this award intends to honor. Please join me in thanking Dr. Kaplow for her service and in congratulating her for this award.
Can we take a picture now? Oh, there she is. Oh. I agree with Betsy. It's really hard to sit through that. All right. Thank you so much. I'm going to move this so I can see it around the mic. Thank you so much for this award and for the very kind words that everybody said. I am so grateful to be able to honor the memory of Dr. Jermaine Mitchell and continue his legacy of service. And I love the service work I get to do for environment and sustainability, mostly because, as Catherine kind of mentioned, I never have to do it alone. I'm so lucky to be able to collaborate with amazing colleagues and students here at Montevallo and build a more sustainable campus and community together. I want to give a shout out to some of the great partners that I work with on these efforts. First, faculty from all over campus have participated in environmental programs and events. In fact, we've had faculty from all four colleges and over 20 different disciplines list a course to environmental studies since its inception in 2011. Many other campus units have also collaborated on sustainability projects and programs, including but not limited to housing and residence life, physical plant, admissions, student life, dining services, and many, many more. We also have dozens of external partner organizations, including government agencies, nonprofits, and businesses. And environmental studies students have completed over 40 different internships and 10 group capstone projects with these partners since 2016. We have also hosted thousands of students and community members at the Lake, Swamp, Garden, and Observatory through the UM Environmental Education Program, and for events like Earth Week and Earth Fest, Valocycle Group bike rides, garden work days, community cleanups, film screenings, make and take events, and more. And so clearly none of these things would have ever happened without the help of many different students, faculty, staff, community members, all of whom have made their own commitment to sustainability. So if you haven't participated in anything environmental yet, I want to take this opportunity to invite you to do so. I would love to hear your ideas about how we can make Montevallo a more sustainable and inclusive place. So come and find me in the tower, or probably more likely in Fallon Hall, and let me know what you want to do, and we can make it happen together. Thank you again for this great honor.
In addition to recognizing outstanding contributions made by full-time faculty, the University of Montevallo also honors the extraordinary work of our part-time faculty. Without their contributions, students would not have the academic experience before them. This year's recipient for the Outstanding Adjunct Teaching Award is Dr. Lynn Kirkland. Dr. Kirkland teaches literacy courses in our elementary and early childhood education programs. One of her recommenders noted that Dr. Kirkland should be recognized for her exceptional instruction, positive influence, collaborative nature, and supportive leadership. The nominator goes on to say, as an educator at all levels for more than 30 years, Dr. Kirkland exemplifies the essence of a passionate and committed teacher. Dr. Kirkland's dedication to education is demonstrated through her commitment to the betterment of students' lives through learning. Dr. Kirkland's literacy advocacy continues outside the walls of the classroom into the local community, where she volunteers in weekly literacy tutoring in her spare time, providing a crucial contribution. Dr. Kirkland's students describe her as patient, approachable, and knowledgeable, an instructor who gives you real-world connections with every lesson and maintains high expectations for her students. Dr. Kirkland joined us after serving for many years as a teacher with Homewood City Schools, then a teacher educator, department chair, and finally dean in the School of Education at the University of Alabama at Birmingham. In addition to supporting literacy courses, she engages in academic advising, she participates in program meetings, and also compliance with state regulatory agencies and accreditors. In truth, Dr. Kirkland has been instrumental in ensuring that our educator preparation programs affected by the Alabama Literacy Act have that delicate balance between developmentally appropriate practice and compliance with statutory requirements. Would you please join me in congratulating Dr. Kirkland?
I did not prepare anything to say, but I would like to say thank you to the faculty in the College of Education and Human Development who have been so welcoming and supportive, and to the students that I've taught. You all are just the bomb. So I really have enjoyed coming back to what I really love and have been passionate about. When you've worked in administration for a while and you get to come back and teach what you love, that's just the best. So thank you so much.
Good afternoon. Today I'm here to introduce the first ever Staff Senate Award. This award has been created in the memory of our dear friend and colleague, Johnny Holsenbach, who unfortunately passed away this summer. The purpose of this award is to recognize a University of Montevallo staff member's dedication and service to the university students, colleagues, and citizens of the greater community. If you had the honor of knowing Johnny, and if you spent any time with him while he was out grilling at an athletic event, or volunteering in the community, the Boys and Girls Club, or the City of Montevallo Parks and Rec Board, or even if you took a moment to brighten your day, you would agree that that statement is who he was. From here forward, this award will be known as the Johnny Shine Holsenbach Award, or the Shine Award for short. I wish I was presenting the Shine Award to Johnny himself, even though he'd probably say that he was undeserving of such recognition. Thank you.
Good morning, university community. I have the privilege of serving thousands of loyal Montevallo alumni as president of the National Alumni Association. And today, I have the distinct honor of awarding three deserving award recipients, including a staff member, faculty member, and an alum for their extraordinary commitment and service to the alma mater we hold so dear. Our first award recipient, Kira Thomas, has been a devoted staff member for more than 10 years. She began working as the executive assistant for the VP of Business Affairs and has served in a few different roles at UM. Since 2017, she has served as the Director of Marketing and Communications. Thoughtful planning, a calm spirit, and a desire for excellence are her keystones. Kira's job requires almost constant attention. She is never truly done with work and remains on call 24 hours a day. Whether it's a weather situation, pandemic, communication, facility issue, social media, or news story, she ensures that the university community is informed and represented in a positive way. Under Kira's leadership, the department developed and implemented the You Belong at Montevallo marketing campaign. It's my favorite. As an alum herself, she knows firsthand how true this is. And when she receives well-deserved praise for her work, her response is the mark of a true leader. She is quick to give credit to her team. In everything, she handles situation with poise, professionalism, gratitude, and outstanding service. For this reason, we are proud to honor her today with the Outstanding Service Award. Kira? Congratulations, Kira, and thank you for all you do for our alma mater. The Outstanding Commitment to Teaching Award recognizes the dedication of our faculty to the students we serve. Dr. Jason Newell, Professor of Social Work and Director of the Social Work Program, exemplifies such dedication. Dr. Newell joined the faculty in 2008. He has received high accolades in his time at UM, including the College of Arts and Sciences Excellence in Teaching Award in 2012, the Alabama-Mississippi Social Work Educator of the Year for 2016-17, University Scholar in 2018, and later today he will be recognized as the university's first Dr. Janine Cannon Bozeman Chair of Social Work. Dr. Newell's passion and enthusiasm for social work shows through his instruction. During the past 15 years, he has enriched numerous Montevallo students' lives. The Alumni Association received highly impressive stories and words of praise about Dr. Newell, not just from students and alumni, but also fellow faculty and staff members. Person after person described how dedicated he is in his teaching and how he truly cares about each student. One student wrote, he is exactly what I came to Montevallo for. He is passionate, knowledgeable, friendly, and highly skilled, not just in his field, but as a teacher as well. Dr. Newell, please come forward.
Where's Alyssa?
Thank you. Thank you. We are so proud to recognize you for this award.
Well, thank you. My former chair, Dr. Holquist, would say, don't give that man a mic, so I will take a minute. My ceremony is later this evening and this afternoon, but I'd like to thank my parents who are sitting there, my sister and my daughter, Eliza, for being here today, my little cheerleader. And thank you for cheering me on this year. And I'd like to thank my colleagues who are sitting in front of me here to my left and right. It's a joy to work with you and to know you. And most importantly, my students. You're the purpose of my work, and I appreciate being able to be involved in your life at University of Montevallo. So thank you all.
Our final recognition today will be the Mary Lou Elder Williams Alumni Loyalty Award. Named for a former student and alumni director of UM, it reflects the values and commitments that we uphold as citizens of a scholarly community. Dr. Susan Vaughn epitomizes these values. Dr. Vaughn graduated from UM in 1971 with a concentration in social work and a minor in history. She went on to earn a master's degree in social work from the University of Alabama and a doctorate from Case Western Reserve University. After working as a child welfare worker, she returned to Montevallo to serve as an instructor and later professor in social work. She trained future social workers at UM for 34 years before retiring in 2009. She has always been generous in her financial support of UM scholarships and providing for students in need. She worked with Dr. Newell to endow the Dr. Susan Vaughn Advocacy Scholarship for our junior or senior social work student, demonstrating financial need and a strong desire to help vulnerable, underserved populations through advocacy and community service. Dr. Vaughn's devotion to the university is unquestionable. After a decade of retirement, she continues to recruit students to UM and to stay in touch with the thousands of students she taught over her long career. She has been an unwavering supporter for all things Montevallo. It is with great pleasure that we can recognize Dr. Susan Vaughn as the recipient of the 2023 Mary Lou Elder Williams Alumni Loyalty Award. Unfortunately, Susan cannot be with us for this ceremony today, but she will be honored with our other two recipients at a dinner this evening. As the Alumni Association's award dinner this evening, we will also have the pleasure of recognizing the 15 within 15. In 2021, the Junior Board established the 15 within 15 honor to recognize 15 driven UM graduates who have demonstrated strong leadership and career passion within the first 15 years after graduating from UM. We are excited to celebrate this group, which includes today's keynote speaker, Ms. Julia Maloney. If you are among the 20 of 23, class of 15 within 15, please stand. We look forward to celebrating your achievements along with your guests this evening at the UMNAA Awards Dinner. Now I'd like to say a few words to our seniors. First, let me congratulate you for reaching this achievement in your academic career. Soon you will be alumni, and there are many opportunities to continue to serve and lead at UM. Stay connected and enjoy those dear friendships you've made over the years. Expand the growth you've experienced as a student through service and leadership as an alum, and provide financial support for the next generation of UM students, just as current alumni are doing for you now. The Alumni Association is proud of you and here for you. And remember, you always belong at Montevallo. Thank you.
Thank you, Stephanie. Let me add my congratulations to our award winners today and my thanks for all your contributions to the life of our university. Ladies and gentlemen, we are on the home stretch. I do have one very quick reflection to share with our seniors. This morning I was on the phone as I walked to work with Cody Hodge, who many of you remember was last year's SGA president and is now in law school at the University of South Dakota. And as we spoke, I said to him what I've said to quite a few people recently. I have a lot of hope for this class, this senior class. I have a lot of hope for this generation. And in so many ways, I think you're better than my age group was at your age. I think you're better than my generation. I think you're more altruistic. I think you're less materialistic. I think you care about people who don't look like you more than my generation. I think you're better in a lot of ways, and so I look forward to hearing what you're doing in the world, and I hope you'll always come back and peek your head into Calkins Hall and say hello to us. So with that, on behalf of the Founders Day Committee, I invite all gathered here to join us for lunch and fellowship following the ceremony. Serving lines will be in the cafeteria with seating throughout Anna Irvin Dining Hall. We sincerely appreciate your attendance to this celebration and ask that you remain with us for the dedication of the Allen and Lindsay Song Center for the Arts at 4 o'clock today, and for the comprehensive campaign launch at 4:30, also at the theater. We wish you safe travels home and hope that you will return to campus often. I now ask Mr. Banks and Mr. Giles to come forward and lead us in the singing of our alma mater, the words of which are printed in your program. Following, Ms. Aubrey Chastain, student trustee, will deliver the benediction. Will you please stand and remain standing throughout the recessional?
Let us pray. Our Father, thank you for this opportunity to come together to celebrate the past of Montevallo's founding, but the future of all the seniors here graduating this fall and spring. May you walk and guide us through our future endeavors. We thank the faculty, staff, and parents who have helped pave the way for our futures and make today possible, and honor those who have won awards. It is in your name we pray. Amen.